Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We were discussing cannabis sativas, and the cannabis sativas almost contain 483 types of compounds in a plant, and among them about 65 types of cannabinoids are discovered yet, in which cannabidiol is one of the most important, and the tetrahydrocannabinol is found in these compounds, along with these compounds. If we talk about the history, it is used most recreationally as a medicinal drug to about 2500 years ago, and millions of people of the world are now suffering from the addiction of the cannabis globally. And the age between the person which are affected by the addiction are the ages of 15 and 65, and it is the most commonly used illegal drug in the worldwide. There is some legal restrictions as well, however it is very much prevalent in the world, and it is illegally marketed in Zambia, in the United States, in Canada and Nigeria. So there are various part of the world where its addiction is still common and still needs the focusing. These are the forms of the cannabis that are available. These are hash, sativa, dabs, wax, K2. Other street names are pot names, weed, ganja, bhang, marijuana, grass, etc. And it is the cultivated form. How it is cultivated, and it is worldwide cultivated illegally. These are the marijuana plants. If we talk about the cannabinoids and their receptors and their uses, several cannabinoids, especially cannabidiol is the major component, and there are different other types of cannabinoids as well, there are which exhibiting different types of effects. And mainly if we talk about the synthetic cannabinoids, they encompasses the variety of the chemical classes, and these chemical classes basically similar to the carcinoids, and they are related to the endocannabinoids. If we talk about the uses medicinally, cannabinoids can be used for the treatment of chemotherapeutic chemotherapy induced nausea. So, its main function is that it is for the treatment of nausea, for the suppression of the chemoreceptor trigger zone. It is suppression karne ke liye basically used hoti hai, and for the treatment of the spasticity, which is the possibility of the neuropathic pain. If we talk about the cannabinoid receptors, basically there are two types of receptors. One receptors are found in the CNS, and the cannabinoid receptor type 2 is present in the peripheral nervous system. And physiological and behavior effects are mainly produced due to the cannabinoid receptor type 1, CB1 receptors, which are basically G protein coupled receptors. They are specifically found in the basal ganglia, in the limbic system, and in the hippocampus and the striatum. Furthermore, they are also present in the cerebellum and in the male reproductive system, in female reproductive system, and they are not present in the medulla oblongata, and which is a part of the brain stem, responsible for the respiration and the cardiovascular function. It is also found in the human anterior eye and the retina. The if we talk about the second type of receptors, which are CB2 receptors, they are predominantly found in the immune system, and immune derived cells, and they are present in the microglia, and in some extent they are also found in the human cerebellum. They are basically responsible for the immune modulation. There are certain phytocannabinoids are also there. We are not going to discuss. Their general function and their the general classification are the same. So, we will try to understand what is the mechanism. If we talk about the mechanism, they produce their effect by binding to the their receptors in present in the CNS. And basically, if you talk about their agonist, which is the dronabinol, which is a synthetic cannabinoid, is basically used to treat emesis and to stimulate the appetite. And furthermore, it can also produce euphoria and drowsiness and relaxation. And it also decreases the short-term memory and the mental activity, and decreases muscle strength and impairs highly strengthened muscles, like the person is unable to drive a car. It can stimulate the receptors, which are CB1 receptors, as we mentioned here, and endocannabinoid receptors, which are present at the periphery. And excitation of these receptors is basically causing the depolarization and influx of the calcium, and increase calcium levels basically stimulate the synthesis and the release of endocannabinoids. These endocannabinoids bind to the cannabinoid receptors, and basically after the binding they stimulate the postsynaptic neurons and stimulate the neurons, and activated receptor modulates the release of inhibitory neurotransmitters such as GABA or the glutamate. Okay, so then they are producing this effect in such a way that they are basically responsible for the activating of the brain reward pathway. Second criteria ye hai ki they will also responsible for the activation of the brain reward pathway. How? And they are responsible for the changes in the basal ganglia. Once they are going through, they activate the central nervous system and medial limbic pathway. And after that, continuously activation of the cannabinoid receptors lead to the reduced dopaminergic signaling in NACA and dorsal striatum, and it decreases or loss of motivation towards the non-drug reward, and they are responsible for the neurochemical dysfunctioning, like they are responsible for inducing the stress, inducing the anxiety. They also attenuate the GABAergic and glutamic activity and decreases their response to the non-drug signaling intensifier. So, in short, they basically, when the person goes through the addiction, which is usually occur within a 1 week, they produces the addiction by these mechanisms. Tolerance is basically done, and the person is now start taking the drug in higher quantity to suppressing the withdrawal symptoms. This is the general picture of the prevalence of the cannabis dependence, and this survey was done in 2004. Among them, several countries are there in which its spread is very common, along with the European countries, as well as in the eastern and western countries. Dono taraf ye spreaded hai. If we talk about the most cities which are most affected by the cannabis dependence, among this, New York is the most affected city. which is more affected by the cannabis dependence. Then after that, Karachi, New Delhi, and several other countries, other cities of the popular countries are also affected by the cannabis dependence. And this survey was done in 2018. What was the diagnostic criteria by the DSM? We know that DSM is the Diagnostic Statistical Manual, and for the normal criteria for the substance of abuse disorder, there must be some craving to use the substance, and there will be the wanting or to cut down or stop but not managing, and the person is taking the substance in larger amounts or for a longer than they are meant to, the quantity will increase. The person start neglecting the other function of the life, and they will continue to use even when it causes the problem in the its social life. It makes no sense. The person continuing to use it, and using substance even when the person is in the danger, in the problem, is still he is going to use the substance. And basically, cannabis causing the euphoria, altered state of mind, difficulty in concentrating, and impairment of the short-term memory, and loss of body movement, too much relaxation, increase in appetite, and effects, if it is taken through oral route, effect will start after 30 to 60 minutes, which may persist up to 6 hours. Short-term effects are followed by the long-term effects, and the long-term effects are basically the addiction and decreased mental ability, and chronic coughing, and decreased immune system. Uski immunity bhi kam ho jayegi, because jo cannabinoids ke jo CB2 receptors hain wo bhi affected honge. According to DSM, the specific diagnostic criteria is that inclusion require at least 3 of the main symptoms which are developing within the 1 week of the ceasing or reducing the cannabis use that has been used. So, if 3 symptoms are there, then there will be addiction, and it needs to be quieting, and it needs to be treated. Which is the irritability, nervousness, anxiety, sleep, difficulty, decrease in appetite or weight loss, restlessness, depressed mood, and several somatic symptoms of the discomfort. There is a scale which is called as marijuana withdrawal checklist, and it contains 15 of the symptoms, and just like craving, just like depressed mood, decreased appetite, increased agitation, and it will be rated from the 0 to 3 scale. 0 means not at all, 1 means mild, 2 means moderate, and 3 means severe. And if a composite withdrawal score is giving the sum of the 15, then it will mean that it has a severity of the rating. Jitna number badhega, utni severity badhti chali jayegi. And it means treatment jo hai wo necessary hai for the withdrawal, to prevent the withdrawal and tolerance effect. It is basically the summary of the cannabis dependence and withdrawal symptoms, how it is treated. Exact treatment criteria is very difficult to treat cannabis dependence, and experience with treating tobacco dependence has revealed that this must be the combination of the psychotherapeutic techniques with the pharmacotherapeutic techniques. Yani alone hum agar sirf pharmacological se start karenge to kabhi bhi fayda nahi hoga, unless and until the patient is willing to stop it. Otherwise it will not effective approach for the proper cessation of the cannabis. Thus, the use of medication during the sedation period may significantly improve the quieting rates and the maintenance of the abstinence. It depends upon the behavioral therapy. Pehle hum behavioral therapy karenge, and then it is followed by the pharmacological therapy. इफ द पर्सन इज नॉट जस्टिफाई कि वो उसके थ्रू बिहेवियर थेरेपी के जरिए उसका बिहेवियर चेंज हो, कि सोशल चेंज जो है मोटिवेट किया जाए, सोशली वो सपोर्ट किया जाए, उसकी जो मेंटेनेंस है वो फिर लॉन्ग टर्म रहेगी और उसकी एब्सेंस जो है वो क्विक रहेगी. तो द पर्सन इज मच सपोर्ट बाय द फैमिली, बाय द सोशल ग्रुप वर्कर. And after the successful behavioral therapy, it takes about the 14 weeks to completely withdraw from the cannabis. यानी 14 weeks, यानी at least you can say कि 3 months लग सकते हैं to stop the cannabis. उसको prevent करने के लिए behavioral therapy बहुत ज़रूरी है, otherwise it will not be successful. And this behavioral therapy should be continued up to the 1 year. For pharmacological aid, several antidepressants are employed, and there are several studies are available for the use of the fluoxetine, which is the selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor, and for treatment of the depression, and bupropion, which is mainly used for the withdrawal, reduction of the withdrawal symptoms of the nicotine. Research studies show that there are different of the treatment succession. Usually it is not always यह ऐसा हमेशा नहीं होगा कि वो जो रिजल्ट है वो सक्सेसफुल हों. हाउएवर इट मे सप्रेसेस द सिम्टम्स अप टू सब एक्सटेंट, एंड अमंग देम बुप्रोपायोन इज मोर प्रेफर्ड एज कम्पेयर टू द फ्लॉक्सिटिन. एंड इट एड्स इन द रिडक्शन इन द विथड्रॉवल सिम्टम्स बाय डिक्रीजिंग द फीलिंग्स ऑफ द इरिटेबिलिटी, restlessness and the lack of motivations. It is mainly successful when a person is basically using, start using the cannabis due to the depression, and the person has a comorbid major depressive disorders. For other symptomatic relief, we have other options like benzodiazepines, among them oxazepam or temazepam, or zopiclone can be used to improve the condition of the insomnia, and other like the standard benzodiazepine, which is the diazepam, for the relaxation, along with the meditation, exercise and relaxation techniques. And it is mainly for the anxiety, for headaches, for muscular pains. The doctor may prescribe paracetamol or any other NSAIDs like ibuprofen or magnesium, depending upon the need. The frequency is set, and for that, caffeine is avoided, and use of water is suggested and recommended. If there may be sweating and chills, then paracetamol and appropriate hydration and appropriate clotting is recommended. For the nausea and for the nasal congestion, antihistamines like clomethazine or metoclopramide or proglopramazine are basically used, because the drug is using for the nausea, for prevention of the nausea. And if we are stopping the drug with and the person which is addiction, then there will be more nausea. So nausea ko rokne ke liye phir hame koi aur जो है वो एंटी इमेटिक ड्रग जो है वो ऐड करनी पड़ेगी. अनदर अप्रोच इज दैट के वी बेसिकली रिड्यूस द विथड्रॉवल सिम्टम्स बाय मूविंग द स्पेसिफिकली यूज बाय इनहिबिटिंग द यूज ऑफ द शॉर्ट एक्टिंग सब्सटेंसेस एंड अवॉइडिंग द पोटेंशियल रिस्की रूट लाइक स्मोकिंग, लाइक इंजेक्शन, by the substitution with the use of a longer acting drug administration to the safer route, for example oral route or transdermal route, so that lungs can be saved by the smoking effect, or muscles can be prevent from the damage of the injections. For that purpose, at some cases in severe addicted person, oral dronabinol is recommended for the reduction of the withdrawal symptoms and gradually reducing the substance by maintaining the normal concentration of the cannabis in the blood and decreasing the craving of the drug. क्या करेंगे कि शॉर्ट एक्टिंग को हम रिप्लेस कर देंगे लॉन्ग एक्टिंग से, जिससे ब्लड में फ्लक्चुएशन नहीं आएगी और फॉरन क्रेविंग नहीं होगी. इससे और कि पर्सन जो है वो जिस रूट के थ्रू ले रहा था ड्रग, वो जो ड्रग है फिर उसको फिर वो छोड़ देगा. तो इसमें ये करते हैं कि हम बेसिकली वी आर यूजिंग आइदर ड्रोनाबिनॉल विच इज दी टेट्रा हाइड्रो कैनाबिडॉल एंड इट्स बेसिकली हेल्पफुल फॉर दी रिडक्शन इन दी विथड्रॉवल सिम्टम्स एंड हेल्पफुल फॉर दी टेपरिंग ऑफ दी कैनबिस सेटाइवा. एज वी आर यूजिंग वी आर डिस्कसिंग दी कैनबिनॉइड्स एंड द कैनबॉइड एंटागोनिस्ट विच इज दी राइमोनाबेंट इज बेसिकली यूज for the effectively used in the treatment of the obesity and it has been found for the reduction of the body weight in human and however it is not clinically available, however it is under the clinical trials and it may cause some psychiatric disturbance, like it may cause or induce anxiety or depression. And furthermore, in some cases there is a role of the cannabinoid antagonism in the treatment for the acute dysphoric effect of the cannabis intoxication, and it may use for the treatment of the euphoria which is induced by the agonist of the cannabis. उसके लिए भी जो है वो CB1 रिसेप्टर एंटागोनिस्ट यूज हो सकते हैं, बट दिस इज द डेंजरस अप्रोच. इसमें एकदम स्टार्ट में बहुत ही सीवियर जो है वो विड्रॉवल सिम्टम्स इंड्यूस हो सकते हैं, इसलिए ये बहुत ही हॉस्पिटल सेटिंग्स में बहुत ही क्रिटिकली दिया जाता है एंड दिस इज अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग टू यूज द CB1 रिसेप्टर इन केस ऑफ द कैनबिस एडिक्शन. मेनली जो यूपोरिक कंडीशन है उसको खत्म करने के लिए कैनबिनॉइड एंटागोनिस्ट लिया जाता है. ठीक है, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कैनबिस एडिक्शन एंड इफ यू समराइज इट, तो कैनबिस यूज इज वेरी कॉमन एंड इट्स डिपेंडेंस इज ऑल्सो वेरी कॉमन एंड देयर आर सेवरल कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी विच सपोर्ट्स द आइडिया दैट कैनबिस हैव टू बी विदड्रॉ and there has to be sedate, otherwise the person undergo chronically with the continuous mental illness with complete blockade of the social work, social life will be more affected. After the use of the cannabis there is no social life. Another most important problem is that recently the number of cannabis dependency is now increasing and there are more people which are taking interest in using the cannabis and they are suffering from the withdrawal symptoms and proper counseling is required to avoid such types of drugs, avoid the use of such type of drugs by especially young children, so that the person are not become a victim of the addiction. And it is the responsibility of the pharmacist to counsel their social friends to stop this type of the addiction. These are the references. There are too many references, so hopefully you can understand it. You can ask any question on the Google class. I think it is very clear. Thank you.